Good boy.
Good boy.
Up.
Chase. Yeah, try to be hands off, though. Remember, we're working on the e-call now, so we don't have to be so.
Click them, yeah.
Hands off. Now walk around. Just a couple. So tap on the cuz on the thing because he's all the way up and step on the line. Oh.
Up.
Now grab the line. No! Reggie, don't lead him when he runs away from his handler.
Reggie,
clear.
Place.
Nope.
Now walk towards the place over.
Good boy.
Nice.
Good boy. Good boy. Place. Good boy.
All right, just try one second.
Okay, come on.
Set him up again.
Good boy.
Good boy.
One circle. Good boy.
Reggie just learned this a minute ago. That's why I think it's good that Sharon's bumping him and, you know, because you're bossing him around, you know. He's getting used to listening to you and respecting your position and everything, you know.
Whereas I'm yielding to you. I think yielding
to you as well
is a very important puppy task.
Is this going to be something they start in their living room, though?
You can?
Yeah.
Yes, you can. You can start this inside.
Okay.
You know, if we just, it's a beautiful day. So.
It is a beautiful day. But there's a lot of distraction out there, the blowing leaves, the birds.
Mm-hmm.
There's five of us.
Yeah, we had
four
never done
us.
Place outside.
I'm like two people.
Done, let's go and sit and stay outside, but not place.
So if we leave the collar on him in the house, which is the plan.
Yeah.
As far as when we're in the house, the only thing we'd really be using it for is possibly a place to...
That lets go. So a lot of times if, like, people are in my house or if I'm having a house cleaning problem, which is not your guys' issue, I'll have the puppy follow me through the house so I can keep an eye on them.
Oh, okay.
If he's got the collar on and you don't see him and you say, let's go, and he's not coming...
I'd also get in his eye line, because he's not ready for that across the house.
Yep.
If he's in a bedroom and he can't see you, he's not ready for you to to click him to go.
Well, and that's the thing. When my granddaughter's there, you know, we're always trying to make sure we know exactly where he is. So.
But that's something
And in the house, he could drag a short line just to make it easier for you in case he doesn't listen to you. So to blast him across the
But room. That's something you could practice, too. You know, like having him in your eyesight but away from you and asking him to let's go.
Okay.
You know, then try and make it further and further away.
Okay. All right, buddy.
But just keep the e-collar simple this week, because it's hard when you're getting used to this piece of equipment. That's why I don't have this mask. Okay. I have to give you the plug, too. That's why I don't sell them right away until I know that people are working with them.
Right.
John, do you remember Spawn Insane?
Yes, in the day of rain.
Yeah. Now it's like...
But
it does kind of
come easier than
the leash,
which is
kind of
cool.
Yeah, I mean,
I like him.
The price is right.
Yeah, right.
Something.
I need another.
So this gets
something
plugged in
every night.
Sale price. After you're
done,
and turn it off first.
On
the back.
And he should be wearing this in the morning when he comes here.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we have ones for four dogs, so he'll probably be on the four dog rung. With the rest of the daycare. No, you don't have to bring it.
Okay.
Just don't let them chew it off. We're fine, and don't let your granddaughter hold it.
And it might
never
go through for years. Who knows? You know, that's what I read in the reports.
I read that too.
Did you read it? Yeah, because I thought it was going all the way through.
I wasn't sure exactly what they were saying, like what needed to be reported. I only thought that it was.
That's the way I took it when I read it. That federal money for that.
Yeah.
So if the feds don't come up with a box.
Because at some point they said the state told them.
Or state, or. But I mean, I think that the
but
money
they
that.
They didn't say federal money.
This right down here is this town
money.
Yeah, so they could spend this town money to put that road in and then never get the funds. I mean, I guess they're approved, but who knows how long it would take. I'm not in any hurry for it to go in, obviously.
Seriously. I mean, right now,
right now, what if people's going to be driving down and they don't know where? Just to turn around and come.
Yeah, I guess so. Well, you know what? It'll open up the woods in back of us so they can put in some giant housing development.
That's
right.
Yeah.
So, that could be
good. Because the road will never go through. Then they say we have to repurpose it, so now we're going to make a 500-watt development.
Well, they already, I mean, that's kind of part, that's why they're getting this thing done. That's already part of some settlement that they need to get access to that property in back of us so they can build it.
They were supposed to be through with something by February. I'm not sure what they're
supposed to be.
Someone's going to buy those houses. You know, someone's going to live there and then in another 25 years, someone's going to build another one. Those people are going to go, why do they have to build more?
You know, it's like,
what place was built when we didn't need more? You know, that's the cycle.
You know what I can't figure out, though? I can't figure out who buys these houses for the money that they get for them. I'm like, how much money do these people have to be making?
I mean, overall house prices.
Yeah.
Robert was talking about.
We have one diagonally across from us that's on the market for $550.
Yeah.
It's just a stock.
I was going to say, it's not a beautiful mansion.
No, it's just a stock colonial, like 2,000 square feet. It has no garage and a little yard on a corner.
Yeah.
And the basement, none of us have full basements because the water table's high, but our basement is at least six, seven, so you can walk, but you have to kind of, he has to duck. But I think they have only, you know, got like a crawl space.
Yeah.
$550,000? Yeah. Seriously?
That's because the beach is right there.
I know. It's all about
we
it.
Just had the gentleman who was like this a long time ago, got married, moved out, and they just bought their first house up off of 91 with a road goes up to the reservoir and the quarry up there, you know what that is? Mill Road, it's called. It's, you know, it's tiny, 1,800 square feet, which is the size of my first house.
Yeah.
And no garage on like a slope piece of land.
Our first house is still valued
about
the same. It's
at 400,000.
It was a beautiful house.
I mean, but they're all coming through with granite, the countertops, and stuff.
But still, not only
that.
Well, you know, I have to say, like, it's, I guess I don't know where people get the money, but then I say, well, we built our house with a modular.
Banks are lending.
And, you know, we built the modular, and we don't have any fancy bells and whistles, and I know what it cost us plus the land, and I'm thinking, yeah, if we were selling our house, we'd have to get that too to recoup what we sunk in. We don't have any granite or, you know, it's just like everything.
There are houses going for
14% or 17%.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
But the thing that was great was.
I guess my thing is, it's like, these people are that have that kind of money to buy it. Like, you know, when he was working, we made an okay living. But we weren't buying any $700,000 houses.
Well, this house for us, because my business went down, it's like 55% of the
rates down.
Right,
So that gets you need to refinance.
Otherwise, I have to rent.
But plus you get, you know, we're at least at an age where, you know, we bought our first house for $65,000 and sold it, and then we, you know, so we kept. But I'm thinking for someone, say, like my daughter, not that she's dirt poor, but for her to ever afford a house at even $300,000 from nothing, which she, it's not happening.
You'd have to find, I mean, you don't have to go that far from here.
No, to get reasonable prices. Yeah. Yeah, no, I know. I know. But Robert's right, it's all about the beach.
I have to say, it's nice.
Oh, absolutely. I wouldn't trade that in.
I can just walk in. I don't have to worry about parking.
But I just laugh at, since I've moved here, how when you're living on the beach like we do, how terrible you are. How, like, I mean, it's incredible. And I guess I'm a little like that, too.
Well, what gets me is the people that claim their car on the beach at like 6 a.m.
What are you going to do, huh?
The thing that
we're not making any more money, that's for sure.
The thing that happens.
It's in the west direction.
Yeah.
My days are done, and we're supporting two adult children, so like that pretty much eats it up.
They're living at home?
No, one's in school in California, so she'll be a senior next year. So that's tuition, right? And
yeah.
all that stuff
housing
that goes
food,
with it.
Yeah.
That's expensive. And then the other one's just dirt poor. So we pretty much pay her rent.
Oh, that's nice.
Is she a free spirit or?
The one that's here?
The one that's broke.
The one that's broke?
No, she's not a free spirit.
She just
got a deadbeat boyfriend and had a baby with her.
That's the one. That's the bad gene pool?
Yes. Yes, this guy has had more jobs in the last couple of years.
She's been with him like 5 years. I think since they had that baby, he's had 7 jobs or something. I'm going, I've had 3 jobs in my entire life, you know.
He does cooking, or he does landscaping, or he does whatever, and then
there is a value
in
being able to be that flexible.
He
always
seems to get
it. We used to go skiing in Vermont.
I think he's
our ski instructor will also be like conductors.
Yeah. Oh yeah,
you know, maybe farm goats too. I don't know.
Yeah,
well, they have like 7 or 8 things that they can do because to live in Vermont is even more rural than here.
For a long time.
Not that this is rural, but there are parts of it can be pretty rural in Vermont.
For those that do, it's great. I mean, I can remember guys.
And then once the skiing season's over, you know, everything dries up business wise.
I mean, my daughter works, but she's a CNA. She doesn't make any money.
What's a CNA?
A nurse assistant, you know, $10 an hour, life insurance.
Yeah, you know, in my opinion, they make two.
Yeah.
Not that I want my
oh, yeah.
The nurses make two at
I'm lucky I got out of there.
And have to put up
that was a great time.
You
so,
know what they said?
Yeah.
She's a hard worker, but and you know what it is. I say they can't make ends meet because right now, when they first had the baby, his mother, who's like 43 years old, and he's 25, she babysat for them so they could both work and they were making ends meet. But after 2 years of doing that, and I don't blame her, like that's not her gig, and she was like, okay, I'm done. Well, they can't even. There's no way they can afford daycare on what they make. So basically, he works weekends in a restaurant, and she works during the week, and you know, someone's always home with the kids. So, and they only have one car, so they're really limited.
I'm trying to figure out how we would make it work, and I didn't want. I was scared to death of my kids
being
such a stranger.
Right. Well, that's how I know. We were always. We had a babysitter, someone hooked us up with that, you know, just an older woman.
My parents had my grandmother. But she, you know, was just on the weekend.
So anyway, they struggle. But anyway, between paying her rent and the other one out in California, she shares an apartment with 5 other girls, but she's in San Diego, so the apartment's like $5,000 a month. So her share is almost $900 a month.
Yeah,
it's not like living around here. You know, we're sharing with it, so it's $300 a month, you know. She better be making the big bucks when she gets out. Oh, and Robin, and she's an accounting major. Mommy pushed that.
It's that true for being able to have your business.
Well, it does. And she's right now working for a CPA that has her own business, so she kind of likes that, but it's a small office type of thing.
I'll tell you what, I like when I work for a CPA, but my nightmares about corporate America mainly revolve around the taxes.
Oh, yeah. She got her first. She just got this job in February, so you know she did a little bit of taxes, but she's just training, so she kind of you know saw them. But
I tried to get them all off the board. Not trying to
right.
Yeah.
Well, hopefully she'll be able to be self-supporting when she finishes this.
It's you can self-support.
Yeah,
that's for sure.
And you know, if we're gonna show up that kind of dough to help her in school in California when she gets out, I need her to be able to make a living.
I wish my guidance counselor met
mention other
mentioned dog training and opening your own business, so
no matter what. They were considered, sometimes I'm sure they still are considered professionals in the edge of the line, you know what I mean?
All the famous basketball players.
Oh, well.
Money just keeps on going on.
That's
straight.
At least for the one in school, there's an end in sight. The other one, not so sure. But you gave me a grandchild, so what the hell? I didn't think I'd be having a grandchild.
Hey, you know,
so
I wasn't doing so well when I was 19.
Well,
I didn't have a kid, but I wanted to get out of school, and I did. And then I worked on a little jobs, did a good job at them, and decided I didn't want to work at these jobs anymore, so I went back to college.
Right.
And I had more of an idea of what I wanted.
I did the same thing. I flunked out when I first went too. And then I worked, and then I was like, this bites.
Yeah, I tell people, you know,
it's not far off.
You know, I was going in for music, which is nice, but I know now that I probably wouldn't have stayed with it or used that as my career.
What are you going to do with that, right?
Well, what I wanted to do, see, this was my problem. I was only happy if I could become first chair of the Boston Symphony Orchestra. Not a lot.
You must have been good.
Not that good.
Then it's best you gave up your dream.
Right. Not that good. Maybe if I'd actually put my heart and mind into it, I wanted it to be, something I enjoy.
I tell my kids, you don't have to enjoy it, just make money. If you make money, you can enjoy your life outside of work. It's nice to do both,
but not everyone's that lucky, but it is nice to do both.
Yeah.
Now that I do both, that's why I have nightmares about both of you, which is I was miserable at some point.
Yes.
I don't know,
but the baby daddy, he's an okay guy.
Yeah.
He's one of these tattoo guys. He's got, he's got tattoos on his neck. And so it's like, even if he, he's ruled himself out of so many jobs. He's ruled himself out of so many jobs just because of that.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, I don't know. She always went for
those.
The
bad boys.
Oh,
well.
Keep
having
a good day.
Wait
for the twins.
Yeah.
Gaggy
came and picked for us.
All right, we'll see you
Tuesday.
Sounds good.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
Can I call you,
Robin?
Yes.
Can't figure this thing out.
Yes.
Email. Yeah, or call.
Or call. Whatever. Okay. If I'll get back to you.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
That door is going to be locked because I want to remember Cujo was in there.
Everybody's in there now.
I'm going to close the garage door so you don't step under it. And I'm going to walk this way.
How are you going to get in there?
I'm going to hang this up like so. Now, I'm going to walk around. Fascinating, I know.
Literally.